Good afternoon. This is Nataraj Krishnappa, Director, Other Units, Bharat Electronics Limited. I head the 8 units of Bharat Electronics, which is spread over the country from north to south, east to west. Now, the variety of products are quite diverse. We are into electro-optics, we are into radars, communication systems, we do gun upgrades, L-70 gun upgrades, and then we also are into making artillery fuses, we are into ammunition. So this is a broad product profile of the other units which I am heading. If you look at the turnover of the other units conglomerate, we exceeded the Bangalore complex in the last fiscal. Other units did 5,300 crores versus what my Bangalore counterparts did, about 4,700. So that way it was a big jump of about 1,200 crores over what we did year before that. There has been a steady increase in the execution part of it. Notwithstanding that, we are also aggressively marketing our products in various diverse fields. Like, for example, if I take the latest diversification, the artillery fuses, we initially started with 105mm fuses and now we have migrated to 155, that is the Bofors, which fits the Bofors gun. We also did VVPAT, voter verifiable printer audit trail, for the election commission. In our Panchkula plant, we manufactured about 2.5 lakh machines in the last about 6 months. That was a very aggressive production, what we did there, supplementing our Bangalore counterparts. The fast track order of handheld thermal imagers for the Indian Army was supplied last year. We manufactured close to about 3,000 handheld thermal imagers, which is a state-of-the-art product and which was immediately deployed into in the Indian Army. And it was deployed at across the LOC, and that was a big boost to the Indian Army because they could see things happening across the LOC during night times. Recently, we bagged a huge export order from Elbit, Israel, for manufacture of compass. This is for our Chennai plant. Chennai plant is doing otherwise extremely well. They did the first 200 L-70 gun upgrades. They also have got the further 100 numbers, a repeat requirement sort of a thing. And then they are also doing the payloads, which we call it as compass. And compass has undergone much modification. And the latest, having nine sensors, that's an export requirement from Israel, which we have got in this about in Aero India. The order copy was handed over by Elbit Israel in the Aero India yesterday. There is yet another product which we are, it's not a product, it's a system. What we are doing is called the Integrated Air Command and Control System, which is done by our network-centric system of Ghaziabad. Since this being a very classified thing, I would not reveal much of the detail, but once we complete this, it will safeguard the Indian sky from all the intruding targets. And we will be one of the topmost countries, probably number three. They will be the third country having this state-of-the-art system, which will be deployed in our country. Why this gains importance is, post 26/11, when the Coast Guard, the Indian Navy, approached us, we did this coastal surveillance system that was handled by the Naval Systems SBU in Bangalore complex. But then when we guarded the peninsula, but how do you safeguard your sky? That was the question which was being asked. So we came out with this solution. This is about a 5 to 6 years it went development, and this is being done pan India at 10 different sites across the country. It will be a system to be, you have to experience this than by telling. And I am very sure Indian Air Force will be very happy, and that the Defence Forces will be very happy when this is fully operational. Besides this, we do a lot of electronic warfare equipment, the ground-based alien system, from Hyderabad, the LLTR, which is in collaboration with Thales France, is being handled by our Ghaziabad plant, the radar SBU. All of us know, we are tied up with ISRO, ISRO, for making manufacturing satellite. But in continuation to that one, we have bagged a lot of orders from SAC Ahmedabad and also from ISRO Bangalore. And our SCCS SBU in Ghaziabad is going pretty fine in getting huge orders from the aerospace sector. Now, about the expansion plans, we have acquired 200 acres of land in Nagpur that is primarily for setting up the fuse manufacturing facility and also for storage of ammunition. Our Machilipatnam plant, which is into electro-optics, will be modernized and it will be state-of-the-art electro-optics unit, which is near Machilipatnam called Nimurlu, and we'll be setting up a state-of-the-art facility in Nimurlu. Hyderabad plant, we have acquired about 125 acres of land in Ibrahimpatnam. Now, the broad plans are that Hyderabad normally takes care of the Indian Air Force as well as the Indian Navy. Indian Navy and the Indian Army, so the army base systems will be shifted over to Ibrahimpatnam in due course of time. These are our expansion plans. This is primarily for catering the future requirements of the Indian Army, Navy and the Air Force. On the civilian sector, the latest vertical which Bharat Electronics has embarked on, the Homeland Security and the Smart City, the other unit also has got a stake in that one. The Kodwara unit is out and out in ensuring that some of the cities are made smart. Out of this, the 7 cities in the eastern sector, we are converting it into a smart city. If everything goes well, the Ministry of Urban Affairs and will inaugurate. The PMO office has indicated that it will be inaugurated in Sikkim by end of this March. We are going to do 7 of these cities in the eastern sector a smart city business. We are also, the Kodwara plant is also into railway project. Railway project is railway gate system, which will be an automatic gate system, which will be first time introduced in the country. We will be handled by the Indian Railways. The CCTV project of Delhi will be handled by us, and these are some of the new things we have ventured into. The Panchkula plant has done something very unique, the railway real-time information system, where you have a dashboard where you can map where a train is and which station and which station arrives, which station it leaves. It has got the GPS system, it links to the satellite, and it will be connected to the hub, which will be located in Chanakipuri in New Delhi. And that system we have already supplied. It's undergoing the rapid trials by the Indian Railways. Chris is conducting this trial. Almost in about 12 locomotives, this RTIS system has been installed. And then before this close of March, we'll be installing about 2,500 RTIS systems in 2,500 locomotives in the northern belt. And once it is successful, then Pan India, it is going to be expanded.